Authorities arrest three suspects allegedly involved in the security breach of the Philippine poll body's tech provider, Smartmatic. The suspects, arrested in separate entrapment operations, claim to be hackers who can breach the system of the Commission on Elections. Senator Amy Marcos had first bared the data leak. But Smartmatic officials insisted the breach did not include any data related to the May 9 polls. Facebook has suspended the account of Attorney Vic Rodriguez, the spokesman and the chief of staff of presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos. The social media giant says the account did not follow its community standards. In a statement to ABS-CBN, Rodriguez claimed the suspension was due to his support for Marcos, calling it censorship to the highest degree. The Commission on Elections has identified 104 areas of concern ahead of the May 9 polls, but it did not disclose which areas, only saying they are under constant monitoring. Philippine National Police Chief Donaldo Carlos has said 40,000 cops would be deployed nationwide for the elections, especially in areas of concern. The COMELEC earlier placed Tubaran and Malabang towns in Danao del Sur under its control due to concerns of election violence. It is also looking at placing 12 other towns in Maguindanao province under COMELEC control. The Cusi wing of ruling party PDP Laban will be joining forces with the unit team of Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte Carpio. PDP Laban released a poster hinting President Duterte could join their campaign rallies. The president has yet to name his preferred successor, but he has endorsed 17 senatorial candidates, most of whom were from the PDP Laban Cusi wing and the unit team. The PDP Laban Cusi wing has endorsed Marcos for the presidency, while they adopted Duterte's daughter as their vice presidential candidate. Progressive Coalition Makabayan unveils the list of senatorial candidates it will support in the May 9 elections. The candidates include former Ifugao Representative Teddy Bagilat, former Vice President Jejomar Binay, Senator Laila De Lima, Human Rights Defender Attorney Chel Diokno, Sorsogon Governor Cheese Escudero, Attorney Luke Espiritu, Senator Risa Ontiveros, Attorney Alex Lacson, Antique Representative Loren Legarda, and Labor Leader Sonny Matula. The list is on top of two senatorial bets they previously endorsed, Nery Colmenares and Bong Labok. Makabayan President Satur Ocampo says these candidates share a common stand with the coalition on various issues.
As we manifested in the declaration, in selecting the senatorial candidates to be endorsed by Makabayan, is we discussed, we presented to them the Makabayan program and specific issues on which they agree. Also, as far as the names that are mentioned, we have been relating with them for a long time on various issues, on struggles such as the Marcos dictatorship in the earlier period, then during the Macapagal Arroyo government that we had to work with us because the Arroyo government tried to repress our party system.
Ocampo has this to say about those who criticize their lineup for including candidates who have already been part of the system the group is trying to reform.
Philippine politics is not moving on a straight line, and politicians tend to be pragmatic in certain instances, but there are basic principles, there are basic issues on which the Makabayan has been consistently advocating, with which they concur with us. We are not looking after people who are completely thinking along with us, but who share only certain portions of our advocacies strong enough to consider them as possible allies should they be elected to the Senate.
A faction of Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, which earlier endorsed the presidential bid of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, has switched its support and is now endorsing Vice President Lenny Robredo. The faction's chairman says they informed Moreno's camp they were evaluating other presidential candidates before eventually backing Robredo's candidacy. The faction earlier said they believe in the leadership of Robredo and her competence and experience to lead the country out of the pandemic. Several volunteer groups, including Ikaw Muna Pilipinas, have also recently shifted their support from Moreno to Robredo as well.
This is a party decision that we had with the Partido Federal Pilipinas endorsing Vice President Lenny for her presidency. This is a party decision, I have said, because of several polls from different sectors, no? Different civil society group and parallel organizations. This is purely voluntary and unconditional.
Philippine Election Commissioner Ray Bulay denies threatening to order the arrest of critics of the poll body. Bulay says he only issued a warning to those planning to resort to violence should they not get their desired outcome. Several election watchdogs and lawyers groups slammed Bulay's earlier statement, saying it impinged on the public's freedom of expression. Bulay is blaming the media for the miscommunication.
I never said anything wrong.
You said
I'm not taking anything back. It was the spin on my statement that made everything wrong. Mm. And it is done with malice. With malice and with publication. May karuktong yun. Huwag natin sanang putulin yung karuktong. Mm. Apat ng gulo kayo.
Okay.
Sa resulta ng eleksyon na ito. Kung ang resulta ng eleksyon ay ginulo dahil doon sa statement na minamind condition mo ang mga tao na kapag natalo, dinaya. At yung mga kakampi na mga yun o mga kaanig, yung word wala akong ibig sabihin doon, yung mga kasagpi ng mga yun, ang tingin nga nila dinaya ng gulo ng eleksyon, ay dadamputin yung mga yon.
Bulay also appealing to the public to have faith in the COMELEC.
Huwag na po nating dagdagan ang problema at pag-isipan pa yung COMELEC na mandadaya. Tulungan niyo po kami na magawa yung mahirap naming trabaho at marami sa pamamagitan ng pagtitiwala. Lahat naman po ay ginawa namin na transparent, at least as far as yung committees that I handle, kasi kanya-kanya po kami dito.